The Spirit of the Lord works all the time.
Amen.
I was standing in the hallway, and Chaplain Mike Munroy said, "Hey, smile, it's the Sabbath." And I realized, and my wife, the Lord asked me about this last night. She goes, "There's something heavy about you." You know, and I said, concerns about the week, I guess. Well, the thing that I missed was the ability to take a sigh, let it go when the Sabbath started. So Mike actually recognized that when I'm standing in the hallway. So, hey, take a breath and smile. It's the Sabbath. So I encourage you, if you haven't been able to do that to this point, and then with iVow helping to set the tone of worship, if you haven't been able to relax and appreciate the fact that it is indeed Sabbath, take a deep breath now and leave the drama right on the floor beside you, and we get to worship together. The Sabbath is the Sabbath, not just to worship, because we should be doing that every day, but the Sabbath is the Sabbath because, number one, we get to rest, and then we get to come here, and then we get to worship and fellowship together. So, if you'll take a moment, a nice moment, to look around the room, shake someone's hand and greet them, like they did in Sabbath school, grab a hug if you want to, and if you see a visitor, please invite them to potluck, and then sit with them and get to know them a little bit more.
John, everybody's name. Kim.
Here, and that will be a marvelous time for us to be out here, and if we're going to want to be here at 8 a.m.
In addition to that work, we folks, there's a lot that we need to do in these streets. And I have asked our facilities manager to get with the Dickens, and they went around, took pictures, and Cesar Perez has got a list of things that we must do. We're not going to be able to do it all at once, but we need to do those that need, the ones that we need to do now. And like I said, and I think there will be a surprise. It's not official yet, but if you come, and later on, there will be hopefully a reward for all of us that comes and work and toil hard and make this church and our grounds really a beautiful place in Virginia Beach. So I encourage you folks to please come. Rolling sleeves will start early, and hopefully we'll be done before lunch. Hopefully. Joe, thank you.
That is to say, there is a list of priorities, and when you come to the work bee, that will be laid out so that our time will be utilized effectively. We won't be wondering what we need to do to help. They'll have appropriate stations for us to take part in. And I hope that surprise has something to do with food. There it is again. So, Christopher, please.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It's an honor and a privilege to be in the house of the Lord one more time.
Amen.
It's always a privilege to be in the house of the Lord, to be able to give praise to the Lord our God.
Amen.
Next week is a very special week. Asking everyone to prepare a dish so that they can participate, so we can have lunch together. Come here at 9:30 in the morning for Sabbath school, and then participate in worship. And after we have worship, we will have potluck, we'll have lunch. And right after lunch at 2 o'clock, we will have our first AY. Amen?
Amen.
Our AY is Adventist Youth Society. I've been avoiding seeing youth for a reason.
It's an indirect shot on me, I think.
I don't want to, for those who are convinced that they're no longer youth, oh, it's for the young people, and they had their lunch and they just walk on right on and have it. So this is what the reason why I say AY. We will have AY, praise the Lord. Pray for me and all my team members. Elder Joe is the designated elder for AY. Amen?
Amen.
And I will ask for everyone who would like to participate to be here. I would like also for, with the help of Brother Norman, for us to have choir rehearsal here with the adult choir and the children's choir Friday night at 7 p.m. so that we'll know what's expected. We'll have a run through, and it will be a wonderful time. I hope that you don't think or assume what's going to happen, because you're in for a surprise.
Thank you very much. Okay, now's the time we're going to enter into our divine worship. And we're going to do that with a call to worship. Please take your hymnals and turn to the back. And we're going to look at number 849. Now this is found in Psalms 48. But the responsive reading will be number 849. I thought it was interesting. This is in Psalms 48 of the sons of Korah. And if you care to look at that chapter, it starts out with, "Great is the Lord." So it's another song of praise. This is a relatively short responsive reading. So the congregation will read the bold, but when you do so, it's a song of praise. So be a little louder in praise than we normally may be. Inside your temple, O God, we think of your constant love. You are praised by people everywhere, and your fame extends over all the earth. You rule with justice. Let the people of Zion be glad.
This God is our God forever and ever. He will lead us for all.